Hello and welcome to the Inland Empire Healthy Living Virtual Expo, hosted by the Press Enterprise, Inland Valley Daily Bulletin, The Sun, and the Redlands Daily Facts. My name is Julie Corlett. I'm from the Southern California News Group. I want to thank you for joining us today. This session is being taped and a link will be sent to people who have registered. It will also be available on the scng.com/virtual events website. I'm excited to bring you a musical tribute today by Mike Chamberlain, who is a musician and has quite a history. So if you have a chance, definitely check out his website on his past lives. He is going to give us a musical tribute through the decades. So with that, I want to welcome you, Mike. Thank you for joining us today.
Thank you, Jill. You have a great voice. You could do radio, with that voice. Well, and you're attractive too, but I mean, you have that soothing radio voice. So.
Well, thank you very much. Will you enjoy? I'm looking forward to enjoying your presentation.
All right. Thank you, Julie. Well, let me tell everybody a little bit about myself before I get going. My name is Mike Chamberlain, and I actually spent my career as a television news anchor. I anchored TV news up in Los Angeles and up in San Francisco, Sacramento. I was with ESPN for 10 years. And then I went to Phoenix, Arizona, where I spent the last 20 years of my career, a wonderful family-owned television station in Phoenix, Arizona. But I've always had music in my life. I've been playing ever since I was a kid. I think I first picked up a four-string guitar when I was in grade school. And was in rock and roll bands through high school and beyond, and had great expectations to do big things, but a tour of Vietnam interrupted all that. And when I came back from Vietnam, I kind of gave up music and decided to pursue television, which I did, and had pretty good 40 years in television. But now I'm back singing again, and in retirement, pre-COVID, in 2019, I think I did 326 concerts in 1 year. So anyway, I'm back to doing music full time. So today we're doing music through the decades. I'm gonna hit the 40s, 50s, and 60s basically, but I'm gonna start with a song that transcends all generations, whether you're 9 or 90, we all know this song for some reason. So, and if any time at all you're at home and you feel you wanna sing along, you're more than welcome. So here's the one of three songs I say that we all know the words to. You are my sunshine, my only sunshine. You make me happy when skies are gray. You'll never know, dear, how much I love you. Please don't take my sunshine away. The other night, dear, as I lay sleeping, I dreamed I held you in my arms. When I awoke, dear, I was mistaken. I hung my head and cried your turn. You are my sunshine, my only sunshine. You make me happy when skies are gray. You'll never know, dear, how much I love you. Please don't take my sunshine away. Please don't take my sunshine away. One more time. Don't take my sunshine away. I think everybody knows that song, whether you're 9 or whether you're 90. But I consider that one of three songs that we all know the words to. The second one is Happy Birthday. And the third song that we all know the words to, and how ironic, how timely this one is today. I'm not sure why, just know this is the third song that we all know the words to, and it's timely, you'll see why. Take me out to the ball game. Take me out to the crowd. Buy me some peanuts and Cracker Jack. I don't care if I ever get back, cause it's root for the home team. If they don't win, it's a shame, big ending. for it's 1, 2, 3 strikes you're out at the old ball game. Play ball, which they are. They're finally playing baseball with fans in the stands, and it's all very, very exciting to me. So anyway, the three songs we all know the words to, right there. You can't go wrong with any of them. So let's move into the 1940s. The 1940s basically is World War II, 1941, 42, 43, 44, and 45. And some of the most beautiful love songs ever written came out of the Second World War. And I have this little statue that I travel with when I sing my World War II songs. Let me hold it up for you. Can you see it? There it is. It's the kiss. They call it the kiss. It's just the kiss. And if you ever get to San Diego next to the Midway, they've got like a 100-foot statue of this at the Midway. So anyway, that's what it was all about. It was, they were very romantic songs. Lovers were away from their lovers. The soldiers were overseas. It was just, you know, a very special time, at least lyrically, if not musically. And I'm going to sing you what I think is the most beautiful love song to come out of World War II. And by the way, I am playing a guitar. I'm not singing karaoke here today. I do play the guitar. So this song, I think, represents everything about the music of World War II. And well, if you just listen to the lyrics, you'll understand. Let me move my little statue. It's blocking my microphone there. So the lyrics, if nothing else, will tell you how special this song had to have been in the Second World War. Husbands away from wives, sweethearts that are parted by 6,000 miles. So how about this? We'll meet again, don't know where, don't know when, but I know we'll meet again some sunny day. Keep smiling through, just like you always do, till the blue skies drive the dark clouds far away. And will you please say hello to the folks that I know? Tell them I won't be long. They'll be happy to know, as you saw me go, I was singing this song. We'll meet again, don't know where, don't know when, but I know we'll meet again some sunny day. This song was a huge hit for a singer named Vera Lynn in World War II. She's an English singer, and she was known as the Sweetheart of the Forces. She was Bob Hope before Bob Hope. She used to travel to the outreaches of the war in Europe and the South Pacific. But she recorded this song at Grand Central Station in New York City as the American troops were getting on trains to go off to fight the war in Europe and the South Pacific. And right in the middle of the song, completely unrehearsed and impromptu, all these male voices started to sing, and it was soldiers about to get on board those trains to take them off to war. So it really did go on to become the battle cry of World War II. And sadly, Vera Lynn passed away this past year at the age of 103. She's a national treasure in Europe and here too, to be honest, but one of my favorite singers of all time. We'll meet again, don't know where, don't know when, but I know we'll meet again some sunny day. Keep smiling through, just like you always do, till the blue skies drive the dark clouds far away. And will you please say hello to the folks that I know? Tell them I won't be long. They'll be happy to know, as you saw me go, I was singing this song. We'll meet again, don't know where, don't know when, but I know we'll meet again some sunny day. Oh, those songs, they were one right after another in World War II. I mean, I actually do an entire show called Love Songs of World War II, and it's just one right after another. So, but they weren't all sad and lonely songs. Sometimes I feel they just had to break out the beer and have some fun. So, and here's one from World War II. And it's the only song that I know that has two different titles. It's the Beer Barrel Polka and Roll Out the Barrel. Sing it with me. Roll out the barrel, we'll have a barrel of fun. Roll out the barrel, we've got the blues on the run. Sing boom terrero, sing out a song of good cheer. Now's the time to roll the barrel, for the gang's all here. Here we go. Roll out the barrel, we'll have a barrel of fun. Roll out the barrel, we've got the blues on the run. Zing, boom, terrero, sing out a song of good cheer. Now's the time to roll the barrel, for the gang's all here. Do, 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 do. Oh, they're just fun. So I could keep you all here all day with songs from the 1940s, but we're going to move into the 1950s. And the 1950s is really when rock and roll kind of started with Elvis Presley and Ricky Nelson and doo-wop and all that. But there was also an easy transition from the love songs of World War II into love songs of the 1950s. And when I think of the 1950s, this one really comes to mind more than any. And it's kind of a waltz, kind of a lullaby type song. It was a very big hit for Doris Day, who passed away just a couple of years ago up in Carmel. I think she was 96 years of age, but this was from a movie. And without question, her most popular song of all time. You can sing it with me too. When I was just a little child, I asked my mother, what will I be? Will I be handsome? Will I be rich? Here's what she said to me. Que sera, sera, whatever will be, the future's not ours to see. Que sera, sera, que sera, sera, whatever will be, the future's not ours to see. Que sera, sera. Then I grew up and fell in love. I asked my sweetheart, what will I bring? Will we have rainbows day after day? Here's what she said to me. Que sera, sera, whatever will be, the future's not ours to see. Que sera, sera, que sera, sera, whatever will be, the future's not ours to see. Que sera, sera. Now I have children of my own. They ask their father, what will I be? Will they have rainbows day after day? I tell them tenderly. Here we go. Que sera, sera. Whatever will be. The future's not ours to see. Que sera, sera. Que sera, sera. Whatever will be. The future's not ours to see. Que sera, sera. What will be. Que sera, sera. Thank you, Doris Day, for leaving that one behind. That's for sure. Before I move on to the 60s, I checked with Julie, and we have all gone through a horrendous year this past year with the COVID-19 virus. But somehow we made it through, and we're breaking through to the other side. But some things in our lives have now changed forever. I wonder if we will forever be wearing masks and standing 6 feet apart. Time will tell. I don't know. But I did write a COVID song. It is basically to the tune of an old song called Goodnight Irene. So I'll do a little Goodnight Irene, then I'll sing my COVID song, okay? I don't like that key. I'm gonna change the key on you right off the top here. So, all right, let's try this key. Irene, good night. Good night, Irene. Good night, Irene. I'll see you in my dreams. Here's my COVID song. I wear a mask. Not sure just why, but now I cry because I wear a mask. When this virus is over and life returns to norm, I can say at last, you can kiss my mask. I don't need you anymore. I wear a mask. I wear a mask. I wear a mask. Not sure just why, but now I cry because I wear a mask. Who knows? I sure hope we take them off soon because I've just about had it. So let's move on to the 1960s. The 60s, of course, is the decade that gave us the British invasion and the Beatles and the Rolling Stones, of which I was right in the middle of, for sure. But there was some other music going on in the 60s too. And there were some girl groups, Martha, what was it in the Vandellas? Anyway, Martha and the Vandellas, the Supremes. And this next song came from a girl group called the Ronettes. And it's a very influential song to a lot of people. Brian Wilson of the Beach Boys heard this song. And the first time he heard it, he said he sat down and listened to it over and over 1,000 times. And that song was so in his head that he actually wrote some of his Beach Boy songs off the song. He wrote God Only Knows came off of this song that I'm about to sing. It was by the Ronettes and it was produced by a gentleman named Phil Spector, which is a whole nother story, but he was a musical genius. And so he gave this one to the Ronettes and it's been influential in many different ways. I mean, maybe one of the most covered songs ever. And it's a song you can help me sing too. So anyway, this would be your part right off the bat, okay.
Be my baby, my one and only baby. Be my baby now. Oh, your part again. Be my baby, my one and only baby. Be my, be my baby now. Oh, 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 oh. The night we met, I knew I needed you so. And if I had the chance, I'd never let you go. So won't you say you love me? I'll make you so proud of me. We'll make them turn their heads every place we go. So won't you be my baby, my one and only baby. Be my baby now. Whoa, 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 whoa. I'll make you happy, baby. Just wait and see. With every kiss you give me, I'll give you three. Oh, since the day I saw you, I have been waiting for you. You know I will adore you till eternity. So won't you be my baby, my one and only baby. Be my baby now. Whoa, your part, here we go. Be my little baby. See, you'll be my darling. Be my baby now. Whoa, 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 whoa.
So it was a pretty influential song, that's for sure. But it's a fun song to sing too. I mean, I could say there's some songs you could just sing all day, every day, and that's kind of one of them. So, and I'm working on some other 50s stuff. There were some by girl groups, but I always have to change it because it's a guy singing a girl's song. But anyway, it'll all make sense in the end. So we're going to end today with a song that I think. Perhaps we need today more than we ever have before. The 60s was also a transition from folk music to rock and roll. And there were groups like the Byrds that were very successful at taking folk music acoustically and electrifying it through amplifiers and then taking it to another level. And the Byrds did it, many other groups did it too. And this was a song that I think kind of exemplifies the 60s too, although it kind of came from the folk era. But anyway, it's a good song to end on. I think we basically need this song more than we've ever needed it before, as a reminder of what a truly amazing country we live in and how blessed we are to live in the United States of America. So let's end with this one, okay? It's a good sing-along too.
This land is your land, this land is my land, from California to the New York Islands, from the Redwood Forest to the Gulf Stream waters. This land was made for you and me. As I went walking that ribbon of highway, I saw above me a golden skyway. I saw below me a golden valley. This land was made for you and me. Here we go. This land is your land, this land is my land, from California to the New York Islands, from the Redwood Forest to the Gulf Stream waters. This land was made for you and me. I like this verse. Well, I always wondered what made me proud here, what made me happy to be allowed here. Then I discovered the only answer. This land was made for you and me. Here we go. This land is your land, this land is my land, from California to the New York Island, from the Redwood Forest to the Gulf Stream waters. This land was made for you and me. One more time. This land is your land. This land is my land. From California to the New York Island, from the Redwood Forest to the Gulf Stream waters. This land was made for you and me. I say this land was made for you and me. One more time. This land was made for you and me.
Yay, I play the guitar. Well, thank you. I hope you enjoyed a little trip through the music of our, kind of the soundtrack of our lives from the 40s, the 50s, and a little bit from the 60s. So anyway, I hope you can all join me. I do concerts all over Southern California. I have a website, singingtvguy.com, where you can either contact me or kind of get in touch with me and find out where I am. But nonetheless, thank you so much. I enjoyed doing this today. It's so much fun to be singing music once again, if you will. So thank you so much.